Team was going to be on a back-to-back and haven't really been able to take advantage of that to the course of the season to this point. What can you do differently tonight?
We just got to play good hockey, regardless of, we try to play the schedule when we're on back-to-backs. You got to play the hockey game. Same thing if another team's on a back-to-back. You got to go out and play good hockey. It doesn't really, it's not as big a deal, I don't think, as maybe it had been in the past. I don't know what time they got home. I mean, the biggest thing's sleep and all that kind of stuff. So, at the end of it, regardless of who we're playing or what their schedule was, we have to come out and play really good hockey for 60 minutes.
Hey Jeff, yep. Are you seeing, when you look at the video, I mean, are they much different from the Babs days to these days, or what do you see?
Well, I think there's a couple areas. Certainly in their D zone, their D zone's different. They're more like the New York Islanders right now in D zone, where their wings are in the middle of the ice and collapsed and really trying to protect the net front, where, Babs historically has been a guy who's, what the term we use, cut the top off, have the wings gone over to the wall more than not. So that's a specific area difference. They're certainly very, very active in their old zone. That would be another area where they're more of a five-man unit, where I think Babs had a more of a shooting mentality. I think there's some differences there. In the end, they've got good players that I think when they're confident, like the rest of the league, when you're confident, you play way better. And they've got good players, and when they're confident, they're a really good team.
Jeff, some of the players have said, some of these losing streaks are the toughest stretches they've gone through in their career. What has the season been like for you, like this challenge?
Well, it's been certainly as big a challenge as anything I've faced in my professional career. But we'd be lying if we didn't say that. The record says that. I think it's a great challenge, though. I think it's a great opportunity. I mean, it's easy to have great character when things are going awesome. When you go through these types of struggles, it's a great opportunity for me to make sure I'm leading the right way. And a big piece of that for us has been making sure that we have a short memory, making sure that we're attacking today. There's not one thing we can do about yesterday except for learn from it. We've tried to do that. We've tried not to let frustration creep in, even though that's a human emotion. It's going to. We've tried to block it out as much as we can, and then we've tried to take the day head on. And we got a great opportunity tonight to play Saturday night in Toronto. Let's do everything we can to win the hockey game and keep getting better. So that's been my focus. Am I human and where I've had lapses? And of course I am. But I've always tried to reset myself and say, let's worry about today. Let's worry about getting better today, both as a group, as myself individually.
Within games, when like the other night, you guys had four shots on goal, I think, in the first period. What do you try and do on the bench when you see things kind of go off kilter like that?
Yeah, I think there's differences. Sometimes different reasons for why things go off kilter. One thing for us right now, and one thing I tried to say the other night is we've got to play with more confidence. We can't be afraid to make mistakes. We can't go out and be afraid to get scored on. We got to go out and play to win the shift. We got to go out and play. Really, we don't have much to lose. Let's go out and play like we don't have much to lose. Let's go out and play without fear. Not careless, but without fear, and that's what we've tried to get across to our guys.
John, are you getting the start tonight?
Well, I'll tell you tonight.
Okay. Is the plan still on for Jimmy tomorrow after? I mean, what kind of report did you get about last night from him?
Jimmy played pretty good down there in both games. He did a good job. He's probably will get home tonight sometime. So yeah, the plan right now would be to play him tomorrow.
We talk a ton about confidence with players, but does it affect a coach as well?
Oh, there's no doubt that we're all human now. I would tell you, I think the 4 years of experience prior to this has really, really trained me well to handle a season like this. I would not want to go through this my first year in the league. To be honest with you, my confidence hasn't faltered one bit because I focused on drawing from previous experiences and then also just focusing on doing everything to the best that I can do. I can't control everything. I can control my attitude, and I control doing the very best I can, and I've done that.
As you work your way through this, do you find, though, maybe you get the sense of which players want to be part of the solution here, maybe more than others, or
well, you learn about your group? Yeah, I think that's something that certainly, I think you learn that for sure. When times are tough, big time character. True character comes out, and some guys are certainly have shown they want to be a big time part of the solution, and some guys are maybe the opposite. And so, you know, my job is during the season is to try to, as this continues to be real tough, to try to make sure I'm playing the ones that want to be part of the solution. That's my job during the season. Obviously, Steve's evaluating long term, but my job is during the season to make sure I'm playing the guys that want to be part of the solution.
What kind of feedback have you gotten from Steve? A lot of the guys have said, you know, it's different with him watching all the time. I mean, how often do you talk to him? And because let's be honest, coaches are usually in the firing line when.
Yeah, no, that's, I, you know, we don't, we certainly haven't spoken about anything like that. Which I guess good. You laugh, yeah, right?
Yeah. I'm happy for you.
Oh, good, good. I'm glad you're happy for me. So Steve and I talk every day. We talk about a lot of different things. You know, he evaluates, or he's at a lot of our practices. So a lot of times I'll ask him what he thought, and he'll tell me what he thought. I think he's a great resource that way. Same thing as we go through the year. You know, I think his message to me this summer is similar as message to me today. Make sure our guys are getting better every day. Make sure, especially our young guys, you know, are getting better. We're holding them accountable, and they're getting better every day. So that was his message this summer. Really didn't deal with wins and losses. It was more about the individual improvement of players, and that's what I'll continue to do. And I believe if your guys get better through the course of the season, you're a better team at the end. So you know, again, we're facing this thing head on, and we're gonna continue to do that every day.